अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर ऑल स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 5। आई होप यू ऑल विल बी फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम्स। दिस इज़ योर टीचर मिस तहनियत। एज यू ऑल नो वी आर इन द मंथ ऑफ सितंबर, सो वेलकम टू द मंथ ऑफ सितंबर। टुडे इन द सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश बी वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी यूनिट नंबर 8 व्हिच इज सेंटेंसेस फ्रेजेस एंड क्लॉजेस। फर्स्ट आई विल टेल यू the meaning of the sentences. First I will tell you the sentence. Sentence is a group of words. Sentence जो होता है वो एक अल्फाजों का मजमुआ होता है, group होता है words का, that contains a subject, जिसमें क्या शामिल होता है, किस कोई भी subject, a predicate, and makes complete sense by itself. या तो उसमें कोई सब्जेक्ट शामिल होता है या कोई एक तरीके से प्रेडिक्ट शामिल होती है और वो सेंटेंस, वो जुमला जो है वो अपना पूरा मायने बयान कर रहा होता है, मतलब कि एक वो कंप्लीट सेंस बना रहा होता है। एक कंप्लीट सेंटेंस जो होता है उसमें सब्जेक्ट शामिल होता है, प्रेडिक्ट शामिल होती है और वो एक जो है वो कंप्लीट सेंस बना रहा होता है जिसमें पूरी बात क्लियरली शो हो रही होती है, वो कहलाता है हमारा सेंटेंस। Here you all can see the some examples of the sentence. Now look at the following sentences, in which the number one is the man was carrying a bag full of money. You all can see this is a complete sentence. And the number two is the boys were running to the playing field. This is also the complete sentence which is making a complete sense of any verb or any idea. You all can see the two examples here and can understand that what is sentence. A sentence which is a group of words that contains a subject, a predicate, and makes complete sense by itself. You all can see here that these sentences are making a complete sense, like the man was carrying a bag full of money. And the number two is the boys were running to the playing field. Here you all can see the complete sentences in which the things are completely defined. Nothing is remained undefined in these sentences. Now here you all can see about the phrases. First I will read the definition. A phrase is a group of words which does not contain a subject, a verb, and doesn't make complete sense by itself. It means phrases वो group होता है word का जिसमें subject शामिल नहीं होता, जिसमें verb शामिल नहीं होता और जो है जो खुद से किसी भी जुमले का कोई सेंस कंप्लीट ना कर रहा हो। एक तरीके से फ्रेजेस जो होते हैं वो इनकम्प्लीट सेंटेंसेस होते हैं, इनकम्प्लीट बात होती है, इनकम्प्लीट आइडिया होता है। अ फ्रेज इज़ अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स विच डजंट कंटेन अ सब्जेक्ट, जिसमें कोई सब्जेक्ट शामिल नहीं होता, अ वर्ब, जिसमें वर्ब शामिल नहीं होता, एंड डजंट मेक कंप्लीट सेंस बाय इटसेल्फ, और वो खुद से किसी भी बात का पूरा मतलब जाहिर नहीं कर रहा होता, पूरा मतलब बयान नहीं कर रहा होता, वो फ्रेजेस कहलाता है। नाउ हियर यू ऑल कैन सी द सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द फ्रेजेस। दीज आर द स्मॉलर ग्रुप्स ऑफ वर्ड्स, नन ऑफ विच कंटेन अ सब्जेक्ट एंड अ प्रेडिक्ट। इन दीज सेंटेंसेस देयर इज नो सब्जेक्ट एंड नो any predicate. You all can see they are the incomplete sentences, like number one, full of money. What is full of money? Like here is the no sense of any sentence के मतलब हमें यहाँ समझ नहीं आ रहा किस बारे में बात हो रही है, बस यहाँ लिखा हुआ है full of money. And number two is the playing field. You all can see there is no any subject, like a complete sentence. We have read that In a sentence, we have a complete subject, a predicate, and a complete sense of any sentence. But in this phrases, we have no any subject, no any predicate, and not any complete sense of a sentence. You all can see here the number one is full of money and the number two is the playing field. We called it phrases. These are the examples of the phrases. Here you all can see the clauses. A clause is a group of words which contains a subject. Clause वो अल्फाजों का ऐसा मजमुआ है, ऐसा ग्रुप है जिसमें क्या शामिल होता है, सब्जेक्ट एंड अ प्रेडिक्ट एंड इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ सेंटेंस, जिसमें प्रेडिक्ट भी शामिल होती है और एक तरीके से ये एक सेंटेंस का, किसी भी जुमलों का जो है वो एक पार्ट होता है, एक हिस्सा होता है. इन शॉर्ट दे आर लाइक दी सेंटेंसेज. अ क्लॉज इज़ अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स विच कंटेन्स अ सब्जेक्ट एंड अ प्रेडिक्ट एंड इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ सेंटेंस. वी कैन से डैट they are like these sentences, a complete sense, a complete sentences. Here you all can see the example of the clause, in which the example is the man was carrying a bag and the bag was full of money. Here you can see we have combined, we have joined two sentences with the help of a conjunction which is and, and by adding a conjunction and we have found the man was carrying a bag and the bag was full of money. The two sentences have become parts of a large sentence. Then we do not call them sentences any longer, we call them clauses. This is the example of the clause, in which here is a complete group of word and here is a subject and a predicate also. Now students, I am moving towards an exercise of this unit. So come on page number 40. On page number 40 we have an exercise. Say which of the underlined group of words are phrases and which clauses. So students, in this exercise we have to tell which are the phrases and which group of words are the clauses. We have to identify them by the underlined group. You all can see in the number one, which is a man who was walking through the forest, hear the roar of tiger. Here we have to examine, we have to understand by who was walking through the forests. By this underlined group of words, we have to identify whether they are the phrases or clauses. So the answer of number one is clauses, because this is the complete group of word and it is making a complete sense by itself. Now the number two, the flowers all fresh and beautiful will soon fade. Here we will identify by fresh and beautiful. You all can see fresh and beautiful is not making a complete sense, like what is fresh and what is beautiful. So it is a phrase. A phrase is a group of words which is not making any complete sense of a sentence. You all can see here fresh and beautiful, so it is a phrase. The answer of number two is phrase. Now the number three, my brother, a good footballer, will play for the school team next year. A good footballer, here a good footballer is a phrase, because a good footballer is not making a complete sense, that's why it is a phrase. Now the number four, the travelers who were hungry and thirsty, were looking for a hotel. Who were hungry and thirsty? जो के भूखे और प्यासे थे. It is making a complete sense that's why it is a clause. Number 3 is phrase and the number 4 is clause. So students, now the number 5 and the number 6. Number 5, do not believe all that you hear. मतलब कि जो सिर्फ आपने सुना है सिर्फ उसी पर यकीन नहीं करो. तो यहाँ पर all that you hear is a clause because it is a complete sentence and it is making a complete sense. Now the number 6, spring came but स्प्रिंग आई लेकिन गेव द जॉइंट्स गार्डन नो फ्लावर्स. और उसने इतने बड़े बड़े आलीशान गार्डन्स को बागात को कुछ भी फ्लावर्स नहीं दिए उसमें मतलब फूलों की बहार नहीं आई. सो स्टूडेंट्स यू ऑल कैन सी हियर इट इज़ मेकिंग अ कम्प्लीट सेंस डेट्स वाई इट इज़ अ क्लॉज. नंबर 5 एंड नंबर 6 बोथ आर द क्लॉजेज. Now students, here we have number 7 and number 8. Now the number 7 is the scholar was sitting all by himself in the library full of books. Students, you all can see a change here in which we have two underlined sentences, two underlined group of words here. In which the number 1 is all by himself and the number 2 is full of books in the number 7. So we will identify both of them. We will identify first all by himself. मतलब कि उसने खुद से. All by himself is a phrase and full of books is also a phrase. What is full of books? We don't know what is full of books, that's why it is a phrase, and phrase is a group of words which is not making any sense of a sentence. Like you all can see, all by himself is also a phrase because this is not making any sense of a sentence, and full of books is also a phrase because it is also not making a complete sense of a sentence. Now the number 8, in her new clothes the girl looked as pretty as doll. You all can see we have two underlined word of groups here, in her new clothes and as pretty as doll. We will identify the first, in her new clothes. In her new clothes is a phrase. As pretty as doll is also a phrase because they are not making a complete sense. Like in her new clothes means what is in her new clothes? They have not defined here what is in her new clothes. And as pretty as doll, what is as pretty as doll? It has not defined here, that's why it is also a phrase. Phrases are that group of words which do not have a subject, a predicate, and not makes a complete sense by itself. That's why the number 7 and the number 8 are phrases. Now the number 9 and the number 10. Number 9 is Bill looking sad and upset. Said that he had lost all the tickets for the test match. Bill जो कि sad और upset दिख रहा था और उसने कहा कि उसने test match के तमाम tickets खो दिए हैं. So the number 1, looking sad and upset. Looking sad and upset is a phrase here, and he had lost all the tickets for the test match is a clause because it is making a complete sense. Now the number 10, during the vacation, now only a month away, we shall go to an adventure camp. इसमें कह रहा है कि इन वेकेशंस के दौरान कुछ महीने पहले हमें कहाँ जाना चाहिए? एडवेंचर कैंप में. So during the vacation, during the vacation is a phrase because it has not defined which vacations like summer or winter. They only said here during the vacation. So during the vacation is phrase. As you all know, phrases are the incomplete sentences because they do not make any sense. And now only a month away. Now only a month away is also a phrase because it is also not making any sense here. So students, let me tell you that we will only do 10 parts of this exercise. And you all have seen we have completed this exercise here. And I hope you all have understood what are sentences, phrases and clauses. And I hope you all have understood well in this exercise also. So I will send you this work on your WhatsApp group, or you all can do this exercise from here of the month of September. Now the time of the today's session has been ended. Till then, Allah Hafiz, stay home and stay safe.